though?
There is no God.
Whoa.
It was on the movie.
It's from the movie. It's from the movie. I didn't expect him to do that.
It was from the movie.
You She's about to kick your ass, right?
Like, you don't say that in this house.
I'm leaving that in too.
Like, what the fuck is wrong with this nigga?
That's the start of the show.
That was the start of the movie.
It's true. I guess it fits.
Like, damn.
Should I put that before the intro?
Do it, yeah. There is no God.
Oh my God, they're like, gonna not listen.
What the fuck?
Oh man, we gonna lose listeners with that shit.
Disclaimer: anything you hear now. No, shit. Disclaimer. Anything you hear in the beginning of the movie. Shit. It's not a movie. Shit. Disclaimer.
Oh, man.
Anything you hear in the beginning of the podcast is not my words. There is no God.
He said it.
There you go.
Well, I mean,
shall we start?
I guess.
Okay.
I'll have to figure out how I'm gonna do this now. You kind of put me in a predicament there.
I believe in God, guys, just to let you know.
You just talked about it in the last episode. That's why I was like, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah, yeah, right? Right? Damn. Okay.
Oh, shit. That was on your toes, man.
Yeah, right?
On your toes here at Home Video Hustle. I guess the episode started, so yeah, I'm Brent.
And this is PJ.
And this is the Home Video Hustle.
Hustle motherfucking hustle.
Yeah, if you don't know by, you know, reading the title of the episode you're watching, or by what he just said, we watched Psycho 3.
Yes, we did.
And you know what that means?
What does that mean?
It means it's Halloween time.
Oh, shit.
All month.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing but horror movies.
Yes.
We didn't do a bag for this one because PJ just really wanted to see Psycho 3 because he really liked Psycho 1 and 2.
Yes, yes.
So PJ,
yes.
I want you to do something here.
Yes, sir.
You like Psycho 1 and 2, right?
Yes.
We'll both try and recap the movies before this since we didn't do them on the show. You pick one of the ones to recap and I'll do the other one.
I honestly can't recap them.
You can't even, I thought you would have just said the first one.
But yeah, I know that's the one I was going to do, but I don't.
All right, we'll do it like this. Just because we didn't do them on the show before, it's slight baby recap.
Okay.
Because the original one, most people know anyway.
Okay.
The second one, maybe not. But.
One is the one that is the black and white?
That's the original one. That's, yep.
Oh.
Alfred Hitchcock.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, long story short.
Yeah, we're going to keep it real short here.
There's a crazy motherfucker named...
Norman Bates. Hey, he runs the Bates Motel.
Yes.
With his mother.
Quote unquote.
Yeah, you'll find out later. Girl wants to marry your boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
I forget exactly what it is. He's not either not feeling it or something.
Yeah.
And so she's at a job and she gets a big bunch of money. And they're like, hey, go take this to the bank. And she instead of taking it to the bank, she goes, buys a new car,
and runs says, off. Fuck y'all.
Exactly.
I'm out. I would do the same thing.
She gonna use that money, go holler at her dude, say, look, we gonna run away together with all this money.
Mm-hmm.
But stops at the Bates Motel.
Boom.
Shower scene happens, if you know what I'm talking about.
There you go.
Doom, doom.
Exactly how it goes.
I fucking love Psycho. So yeah, she dead as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Investigator comes along with the girl's sister to figure out where the fuck she went.
Right.
Investigator gets his ass murdered and falls down the steps in hilarious fashion.
I forgot that part happened.
Yes, yep. They actually redid it in this movie we just watched.
Yes, they did.
So he dead as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Sister and her and the girl's boyfriend, they come and investigate. Come to find out, Norman Bates' mom been dead.
What
this whole
happened?
Time.
Yeah,
she's stiff as fuck. She's a mummy.
Oh.
High comedy. So then you find out that the woman that's been running around his mother is Norman
actually
Bates.
Yes. Oh,
didn't mean to say it that fast, bro. I apologize.
No, it's okay.
But Norman Bates is the mother.
Mm-hmm.
He runs down there with a dress on and a wig on and smiling all crazy in hilarious fashion.
Yes.
He gets captured by the police. The
popos.
This doctor explains the whole movie pretty much. Come to find out, all the bodies are in the swamp.
Mm-hmm.
They drain the swamp, and there's a car coming out. It's got the body in the trunk.
There you go.
That's the end of Psycho 1.
Yes.
Psycho 2 is slightly more complicated, and I haven't seen it in a little while, but I love Psycho 2.
I haven't either.
22 years after the first movie, and it even came out 22 years after the first movie.
Amazing.
Alfred Hitchcock is now dead, so he did not direct it. Can't remember the dude that directed it right now. PJ's drawing it, but he don't even know
somebody
what I'm talking
about. Nope.
So he's out of the nut house, back at his house.
Yes. Okay.
Marion's sister, the girl that died in the shower in the first movie, you remember? Yeah, her sister's back. And basically, this whole movie is just her plot to make Norman Bates either go crazy or, like, seem crazy enough to get put back in jail. So her and her daughter are just doing shit
fucking
this whole
with
time.
Him.
And you find out that the killer in the movie has been the sister, if I recall. I don't think Norman Bates killed it.
No.
Well, he does kill somebody. We'll get to
who
that.
Who did he kill?
Oh. Ho, ho, ho.
In the second one?
Oh.
I thought it was just the sister.
PJ.
And...
Oh, PJ. What is our favorite scene in Psycho 2?
Oh.
Yes.
Yes.
He kills somebody.
Yes, he does.
In hilarious fashion.
Yes.
All that happens. Like I said, the whole movie just the sister and her daughter trying to make motherfucker go crazy. Sister eventually gets her ass murdered super hard.
Yeah.
Norman Bates puts the knife in her mouth and it goes through her neck. So I guess he did kill her, now that I think about it.
So he killed two people.
I forgot he did shank her ass finally. But nobody give a fuck because she was shitty anyway.
Right.
And then basically Norman Bates just sitting at home chilling. Old woman comes in. Her name is Miss Spool. Emma Spool. And she says, hey, you know, I'm your real mama. And he's like, oh, word?
Oh, really?
Conk.
With a shovel.
Hits her in the head with a shovel. And me and PJ rewound that several times.
So I believe that we spoke on this before, haven't we?
On one episode of the show, we talked about how Uncle Michael got mad because we kept rewinding that shit over and over again because it's hilarious.
Right.
And he takes her body upstairs to go stuff it and become the new mummy. High comedy again here, folks. And that basically is Psycho 2.
There you go.
Real basic, simple recaps there.
Yes, yes.
And that leads us to what, PJ?
Psycho 3.
Hey, the first movie in our Halloween Havoc series.
Yes.
And yes, I'm stealing that from WCW because WWE ain't using it. So guess what? Home Video Hustle is not Halloween Havoc this month.
God damn it.
Fuck off. Hey, WWE, if you don't like the fact that we're using that, guess what?
What?
The door.
The door.
Get to it, motherfucker. Hey.
Bitch. The door.
Psycho 3, 1986, hour 33 minutes. Directed by Anthony Perkins.
Mm-hmm.
Starring Anthony Perkins.
There you go.
Diana Scorwid, Jeff Fahey. Anthony Perkins is Norman Bates, if you didn't know.
There you go.
So Norman Bates directed this motherfucking movie. And why? I don't know. And you want to know the other thing I wrote down?
Yes.
That opening line that you keep repeating?
There is no God.
That was improvised by the actress.
I wonder, like, I know what would, hold on, okay, let's just,
go on.
Are we in the beginning?
We started the movie now, yeah.
All right. So, as you just heard, that was the opening line.
No joke. After the Universal logo, it's black, and it just has her screaming, there is no God.
So.
And the movie just starts.
You know, I see why she would think to improvise that in, because they were, all right, so the lady who said it, she was a nun.
Right, right.
And she was practicing with, you know, her priesthood
other
or whatever
nuns.
You call them, yeah. And she was attempting to, if you imagine, I always tell them, imagine, step with me and imagine.
In a world.
Where two black guys get their hustle on.
On a microphone.
What will the review be?
Probably some bullshit.
Let's find out.
Coming this summer.
Halloween.
Havoc.
Damn right.
Hey.
So, if you can imagine the Hunchback of Notre Dame, the big bell tower that has the little holes cut out in them.
I've never seen it.
Oh, fuck. So that means probably some of y'all have never seen it. Okay.
They probably have.
So y'all know what I'm talking about.
They probably do.
Yeah, in the big bell towers, you know, the bells, the dong dong with the rope that goes
ring,
all the way
ding,
down.
Ring a ding 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 dong.
And keep their heads ringing. Hey. Dong dong. What was that? That's Friday Science.
That's
right?
From Friday Science.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Dr. Dre.
Damn right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, I had to do it.
I feel like the more and more we do these episodes, the more hip hop is just up in here.
Well, I mean,
scattered.
It's kind of a part of our blood.
Right.
Here,
right.
PJ,
it's second nature.
Mean,
okay. You're
other
right.
Other than movies, music is what we do
yes,
here.
This is true.
And that's why we just freely do this shit now. Because we tried to hold back. See, you can't hold it back much longer.
You can't fight the feeling.
It's going to come out.
Hey. I was going to take it somewhere, but we're just...
I don't know why we even care about thinking like that no more. Just do it.
Yeah, right?
At this point, people seem to love us doing it.
Right.
Numbers are sky high.
Yes.
Everyone's loving it. PJ.
Yes, they love us.
We need more, damn it. Oh. Give me photos of spot numbers. Really went off on
it. Yeah, right? Wait a minute.
Turned into J. Jonah for a second there.
Said, I don't care. Oh, funny thing. I have to tell you real quick.
Go ahead, do that.
Since everybody... You know, I've met Felix. Y'all have seen Felix. So my boy's character is Spider-Man. Like, that is his man. He cried over Spider-Man 2 when he was whooping ass.
Really?
He said, Spider-Man, Spider-Man. And, like, tears were forming up in his eyes.
The heightness.
Yes. Like, it was too much for him. But he really, I talked to him the other day.
Yeah.
And... my baby mom was telling me that he really legit thinks he's Spider-Man. Like, he tries to shoot.
Whoa.
Ooh, yeah, yeah.
What happened there?
I couldn't, yeah.
Take a breath. One more in. There you go.
He tries to shoot.
There you go.
Webs at people. And he tries
to he doesn't think he put his fingers on his
and he tried. He hopped off of her car.
Oh, he jumped off the car?
And tried to swing.
He can do that? Is he that big of a car?
No, I don't know how he did it. She just said he did it.
He just looked like a motherfucker flying
there, right? Like, we going somewhere. But yeah, I don't...
shit.
Yeah, it brought joy to my heart for a minute.
It brought joy to mine just
then. Yeah, we got it,
man. I got him the movies, too, and everything.
Yeah, that's his...
I got to get him the other ones. I got getting Spider-Man 3 still.
That's his thing. We seem to be doing this lately, running 13 minutes in and then getting to the movie.
It happens.
Yeah. It happens. So, imagine.
In a world.
Where a bell tower becomes the death trap.
Ooh.
There is no God.
Ooh, you keep saying it.
Or is there? A nun is up in the highest of the heights of the bell tower. Complaining about some shit that nobody knows.
She's just screaming that there is no God.
Yeah. Why? We don't know. But the nuns come to the rescue. Everybody runs up the stairs.
They're not really coming to the rescue. They're really yelling at her and telling her to get the fuck down.
Basically.
Saying fuck.
Basically. But as they're doing this, one of the nuns tries to grab her because she's about to jump.
Doing too much.
Mm-hmm. Instead of grabbing her, pulling her back, she pulls her back but loses grip. And falls 15 stories down to her death.
She gets Batman 89'd. Oh, you don't know what that means.
Yes.
Oh, fuck, you ain't never seen Batman.
Yeah.
There's a part where Batman's climbing up the bell tower to catch the Joker. And I think it's a black dude, one of his little goons. Does he kick him or something? He kicks him, punches him, and that motherfucker falls down pretty much the exact same way.
Batman does?
But, no, not Batman.
Oh.
Batman didn't die,
I'm about to say, that would be funny.
Nah, dude basically did like a fucking cannonball down the stage just like she did.
Shit.
I gotta show you Batman one day.
Okay.
It's gotta be after Halloween, though.
I feel like Batman kind of is in a Halloween theme, for real.
I mean, in no way, maybe. I mean, he's like costumes and shit.
Yeah, yeah. You know, Gotham City is... I picture Gotham City and Halloween as being synonymous in my mind.
Really?
Like, it's a thing.
Well, maybe I'll throw that in the bag next week.
Ah, you never know what you're going to get.
Okay.
Well, yeah. So that's the opening.
Yeah,
that's what happens.
Opening scene, yeah.
That causes, what is her name? MC.
Her name is, oh, fuck. Maureen.
Maureen?
Yeah, Maureen. I don't know what the fuck her last name is.
Oh, well. Maureen. That causes Maureen to hate her life and leave the nunhood. So she goes off.
What is that called? Is there a name for that? Like congregation or something? I don't know church stuff, y'all. I apologize.
What are nuns?
Nuns, right?
Yeah, you're right. They belong to something. It's not a priesthood. It's a...
Is it covenant or something? I don't know.
Covenant might be.
Is that it?
I don't know.
I'm just throwing out church words now.
That sounds about right.
It sounds like church stuff. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's go with covenant for now.
That'll work for now.
Okay, so she leaves her covenant, and she starts walking, crying, sobbing.
Desert.
Yeah, right through the desert. Wherever the fuck they were, it was blocked off in the middle of bumfuck nowhere.
It takes place in Cali, so it's in California.
Yeah.
All these movies, I think, take place in Cali.
We need to go to Cali.
We do.
Hey.
Maybe we'll pop up.
And do what? Hustle, motherfucking hustle.
We're going to show up through what? The door.
The door.
All right, let me quit.
Okay. So she's walking, and all of a sudden, this guy named
Duke.
He's, of course, going to Cali to do what? Become a fucking musician. Yes, what else do you go to Cali for?
Legit question. Hey, California.
Porn? That's the only other.
See,
I don't know.
I was gonna say like technology, like Silicon Valley and all that shit.
Ah, that's it.
See,
too.
You went
that's
straight
too.
To porn, and then you probably have the more truthful answer. Honestly.
Hey, bitch, we're renting a house for a week. Come on.
All right, I got a story.
Oh shit.
There's a movie called The Mangler 3.
Mm-hmm.
It's fucking terrible. It's trash.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get closer to the mic. Hold on. Let me see. It's trash. And you could tell, like. I've seen porn before. Yes. So I was watching this movie. I'm like, this looks like a porno house.
Mm-hmm.
Come to find out, they filmed the movie in a porno house.
Wow.
And I was reading about it on like IMDb or something. And it was like the guy that owned the house, there would be times where they would have to like get out of a room and not film in there because they start filming like porn and shit.
Oh, damn. Damn. Imagine reciting your lines while you're hearing fucking in the next room.
Fucking
damn.
Sitting there like trying, you know, get your act on, and then in the next room just some girl and they're just getting a throat full.
Hilarious.
You just hear like you trying to fucking take your
life. I would feel like what's his name? Ricky Harris. Nah, keep that shit rolling. Somebody about to get fucked today.
Go watch Def Comedy Jam if you didn't get that reference.
Yeah, right. You
oh, this shit is that real. Look how I'm popping it, motherfucker. Pow, pow.
Oh my god.
Oh, this is gonna be like last week.
Yeah, right?
You're gonna have to blaze through the movie because you're talking so much shit.
Look, I mean, there's not much to know about this movie.
It's
for real.
It's like a slasher movie.
Yeah. Okay, so, you know, Duke picks her up. They're going to Cali. All
right, let me. I'm a,
interject?
I'm gonna interject just slightly because mm-hmm. I like that you've been running the show a little bit.
Okay.
You're doing your thing.
Yes.
Let's just blaze ahead a little bit.
Okay,
okay. There's a bunch of bullshit that happened in the beginning.
Okay.
So, let's do this.
Let's do this, son.
Duke picks up Marine.
Mm-hmm.
They ride off.
Mm-hmm.
Starts raining.
Mm-hmm.
Real hard. Stops the car. Mm-hmm. Hey, this is as far as we go tonight.
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. I'm gonna go to sleep. She go to sleep. Dude gets a little flashlight. Is looking up her legs, trying to get a peek up the skirt.
Yeah.
She wakes up and is like, hey, what the fuck are you doing here?
Right.
And he makes a move like a motherfucker. Mm-hmm. Like, he starts kissing her and she's mm-hmm. like, why did you do that? He's like, hey, you ain't stopped me though.
Right.
Goes in for it again. Gets out the car and is like, nah, son, I'm out. It's pouring rain, but she still get out the car.
Right.
He tells her, hey, dumbass, get back in here. Nah, give me my motherfucking bag. Right. Throws her shit out into a puddle or something.
Fuck you.
And says, and I will quote the movie here, folks. Stupid bitch. You could have been coming instead of going.
Oh, hey. That's a bar right there.
Hey, he's a musician.
Yeah, right?
Don't be stealing lines for your next song, PJ.
Hold on. Can I just ask?
I thought you were going to say you're going to do it.
No, hell no.
Y'all don't know.
Why is it that when females are in a car and they start yelling, they start da-da-da-da-da, the first thing to do is for y'all to say, let me out. So then us being the guys we are, in the moment, fuck you, you want to get out, get the fuck out.
You know, you ever seen Eddie Murphy, Delirious?
Ah, yes.
One of my, it ain't one of them. It is my all-time favorite stand-up. And he talks about that, and that's the fucking 80s.
Like, why?
He talked back in the day, women say, let me out the car. He said, dude, be like, oh, you know, we'll have none of that.
Mm-hmm.
80s come, girl, let me out the car. Get the fuck out. And it's kind of true because I'm like, okay.
Right? Like, what you going to do? We going to argue the whole time? Like, I'm fucking driving right now. You want to argue? You want to be silly? Get the fuck out. That's what you want
to
do.
Welcome to 2017.
Right. Is chivalry dead?
No.
Hmm.
No.
No?
No. I mean,
it's different.
It's
just different now.
It's not dead.
Mm-hmm.
It just needs a little resuscitate.
There you go. Okay.
It depends on the girl sometimes.
Has a slow pulse right now.
Yeah. It's on life support.
Slow. Yeah. But it's still here.
We probably sound like such assholes.
Yeah, right? But ladies.
We're not, though.
Right. Ladies, if you're listening, explain to me why y'all do that, knowing that your ass will get kicked out of the fucking car.
Oh, you know what? On some real shit?
Mm-hmm.
I've been thinking about doing like Q&As, where people just ask us questions and we do it like a separate episode or something.
Yeah, let's do that.
I'm going to save my answer in case somebody wants to ask.
Okay.
You can answer if you want to, though.
I don't have an answer.
Oh.
That's why I'm asking
that. Oh, you're out, duh.
Yeah, I don't have the answer. That's the dumbest shit.
I don't think they do either.
No. It's just some women's shit. Some women's shit. I'm sorry. I sound very misogynistic right now.
All of them right now.
Right.
Do I have to edit this?
No, fuck it.
Hey, that's what I was thinking. Hey.
So, yes, her shit gets thrown the fuck out.
And so does she.
Get the fuck out.
Hey. Cut from that scene.
Mm-hmm.
You go to Norman Bates is out there killing birds for taxidermy. Eating crackers and peanut butter as he does it. And
this
then you start to replay the end scene from Psycho 2, which made me and PJ laugh because we got to see old girl get hit in the head with the shovel again, start which is twitching. Always fun.
That is the all-time best Twitch scene.
See, that's the thing about it, too. And people have asked us before when they see us laughing, like, why is that so funny to y'all? The shovel hit is funny. It's the twitch that is the icing on the cake.
Right.
I don't care how fucking crazy that sounds either. We laugh our ass off at that every time.
Yes.
She just hit the ground and she just starts shaking and shit. Oh, I can't fucking help but laugh every time.
Oh, my gosh. Having convulsions. Oh, gosh.
Are we fucked, PJ?
I think we are.
I don't care, though.
They about to find out this Halloween Havoc. This is...
Yeah. So after the twitching,
mm-hmm.
Duke arrives at the motel.
Yes.
And he asks for a job because there's like a help wanted sign at the door. And your boy says, hey, yeah, you can work for me. I'll pay you $5 an hour.
That hurts.
1986, P. Maybe that was all right back then.
I don't know.
But $5 an hour always sounded like it's some bullshit.
Yeah.
When I worked at the hospital, I made $9, and that shit killed me.
Fuck.
Man. All right, you know what? On some real shit, I don't know how it's gone so long. I don't know how this is 22 now. I don't know how 22 episodes have come, or 21, and I haven't told no hospital stories. Mm. I don't know how the fuck I've done that.
Yeah, right?
Because I have so many, probably because they piss me off and they make me angry. And I try not to get too angry on the show because then I might say angry shit for the rest of it. And I don't want to do that because I might like some of these movies.
There you go.
But I will say, at the hospital, quick story here. I started out making 908. Got a raise.
To what?
No, I take that back. I was there 3 years. First year, got a raise, and it went up to like
915.
I think like 9.8. Yeah, I think you're right. Like 915, 918.
Shit.
Making like almost 10 cents. Their thing was you had to get a flu shot or you had to get the nasal spray.
For what?
Or you couldn't get the raise. Since we worked in the hospital, they was like, yo, you need to get a flu shot.
I did it
the first year. I don't get sick that often. Mm-hmm. It's very fucking rare, especially nowadays, now that I quit like drinking milk and shit like that killed a lot of that for me. I took that shot and got immediately sick the next day.
See?
So when the next year came, I said, fuck y'all and that shot. Oh, well, if you don't get this shot, you ain't getting no raise. And I will quote myself when I said, I don't give a damn about your 10 cent ass raise. Keep that shit. I ain't hurting that bad for 10 cents.
Right.
I can go out and find that shit on the street, pimping.
Right.
And they got salty about that.
Mm.
I didn't do it. The whole, like, year after that even, I didn't get they shot. Fuck them.
Damn.
Fuck them anyway. See, look at that. All right, now I said, okay, let me stop. It's pissing me off already. Just remembering shit now.
Mm.
You go to a restaurant. There's a reporter in there and asking about Norman Bates and Spool, because Spool worked there. Cops basically tell Girly, hey, get off that shit. Norman just won't be left alone. Leave him the fuck alone.
Mm-hmm. But in typical movie fashion,
Norman Bates walks right in, too. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They start talking. She starts trying to grill him about shit. And he's basically not having it. But then he looks out the window.
And who does he see?
He sees Marine.
Oh,
but
shit.
Then the thing about it is, she got short blonde hair. And then she got an old school type dress on.
Yes.
So what's that remind him of? Exactly. Reminds him of Marion from the first movie, the girl that got stabbed up in the shower, not in a good way.
Flashback.
Hey. So his attention is immediately gone from old girl.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of everything, when she comes in, she's carrying a briefcace. Her initials are MC. What is that? Marion Crane. That's right. Same initials as her. So he's wigging the fuck out now. He's trying to hurry up and get out of there. And there's even a point where she like reaches down for something. And it like starts going like slow-mo. And they like lock eyes and shit.
Yeah.
And that's when he just gets up like, no, I got to go.
Fuck that shit.
Gotta go, I'm out.
He pays. As he's paying, she asks if there any place for hotels that she can spend the night
or
at.
Yeah, any cheap motels around.
And this guy.
That motherfucker got the jets.
Fuck that shit.
Fuck the bullshit. I'm out. I'm about to hit what? the motherfucking dough.
Dough.
Audi 5000, G.
Right.
Guess what? She comes to the base motel.
Mm-hmm.
And then, to make matters even worse, Duke is working there now, as we said, and he puts her in room number one. What does room number one remind him of, PJ?
Dun, 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 dun. Ah!
Doom, doom. Doom, doom. Yeah. That's the room where he killed her in the shower. And that's the room that has this little peephole inside of the wall. Right. Context. So,
I really first thought that peephole was a fucking glory hole.
I mean, like, PJ, here. Fuck? I mean, that's not a big hole.
Yeah, no, I didn't. Yeah, you're right.
See, I've never thought that.
When I first saw it, though, when I first saw the Psycho 1 and he, like, first moved, I was like, what the fuck is he about to do? Like, just stick his dick through the wall or some shit? Hey, I'm like, ah.
Hey, girl, come here. Got a surprise for you.
Yeah, right?
I never thought that shit before. And I'm usually the one saying the nasty shit.
What the fuck? Yeah.
He probably wouldn't have killed her.
Yeah, right?
He probably would have saved her life.
Just want some love and affection.
Oh, God, that sounds terrible too, don't it?
No. That sounds about right for him.
Moving on.
Yeah.
Norman has to talk to his mama because he's, you know, feeling the type of way right now. And at the same time, he bugging out. Maureen is bugging out because she walks into the motel room and sees a Bible on the table.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, she got issues with that going on right now. So they both just bugging out equally right now.
All right.
Duke is at the bar trying to smooth up on a woman. Come to find out it's Tracy, the reporter.
Yes.
And she ain't fucking with him at first until she sees that he got a matchbook that says Bates Motel.
Yes.
She's like, hey, you be going there? He like, nah, I work there. And she's like, oh, even better. Let me buy your ass a drink.
Right.
Holla at me.
Right. Because the whole thing was he was trying to get her a drink.
Yeah.
But she was just not having it.
One with the shits.
Yeah, but now that he works there, oh yeah, baby, let's come sit.
Let's get that drink.
Right, build a rapport real quick.
Pretty much after she find out her info, though, she leave him at the table.
Mm-hmm.
Duke, though, eyes another girl, so he got somebody to go home with anyway.
Cool shit.
So while they're at the bar talking, though, Norman Baston just wigged the fuck all the way out. Got on the mother outfit. It's about to go in there. You think it's going to be a repeat of the shower scene again.
Oh, yeah.
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 Come to find out, when mother goes in there, opens the shower curtain to stab her ass.
What does he see?
Her ass is already in there in the bathtub full of blood because she don't
split. Bleeding out.
She split the fuck out of both of her wrists.
Right.
Them shits is gushing.
Right. It's so, not funny, but damn.
So the
it's the way she held him up, like, nigga, you late.
Yeah, like, motherfucker, I'm already gone. You're too late, bitch.
Right, try to kill me, damn.
Like, you can't phase me, motherfucker.
I already been phased, motherfucker.
Leaky.
Right.
So, yeah, then the mother side, I guess, gives up because the mother's probably like, oh, well, this
already dead. Yeah.
So Norman takes over, takes her to the hospital, wakes up at the hospital, talks to Norman. Norman says, hey, you can stay at the motel free of charge. Hey, why are you being so nice to me? Reasons. You know it. Why. Now back at the motel. Duke done brought him a little skeezer back home.
Oh, yeah.
But as they're walking up, Norman and them are back home. Norman's talking to his mama. And he hears that shit. And he's kind of like, what the fuck?
Yeah, right?
What's going on? But then they go back to their room to do some of the absolute weirdest sexual shit I've ever seen in a movie.
Right.
And I've seen some weird shit before. Explain. Okay, I will explain this shit. I'm going to try anyways. I don't know exactly what the fuck they were doing, but I can just tell you what I saw.
Mm-hmm.
Girly. Like, his whole motel room is plastered all over the walls. It's just porno shit. Just naked women, like, cutouts. All over the world.
Right, that's
like
what collage. I didn't understand. Like, what the fuck is this? That was just...
It's just a collage.
Okay,
man.
Okay.
You can jerk off and look at any wall.
Right.
All over the world.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Oh, I want to look at you today, girl. Yeah.
No, fuck you.
I'm tired of you now. Oh, my queen, my Nubian queen over there. How you doing? Oh, mamacita. I'm going to fuck with you. Oh, okay. We were silent. We're so fucked. This is a fucked podcast right here. We're sexy, Noah. Okay, I'm still trying to figure out how to explain it. Shit's all over the wall. Girly is like, is she kneeled down or sitting on the bed? She's smoking.
Yes.
She's fully naked. And she's like looking like, she almost like she's doing modeling pictures. Like when they had the light on the model.
Yeah.
And being like seductive
for the photo.
Trying
for
to be
the camera.
All cute and shit.
Yeah.
And then you cut over to homeboy. And he's sitting there fully naked, and he has two lamps, and he's holding them with the top pointed at her like little spotlights.
Yes.
And he's waving them around like he's a fucking airline, you know, traffic man. Whatever the fuck you call it, like you're waving in planes. And he's got one, like, aimed where his dick is, so it looks like, you know, he's, like, blocking it out for the camera. The other one's up at his chest.
Yes.
And it's just like, what in the fuck are y'all doing in here?
Imagine walking in on some shit like that.
You know what? Walking on that, turn around. Close the door.
Right.
Because I'm out right. This shit. I don't know what's going on in here.
That's too weird. You can't even stop in that. Why? Like, nope. I want no parts.
I'm like, hey, I'll be back. You do you, fam. I'm out.
I had a question, but it can wait. Fuck.
Look. I ain't no judging here, bro. You do you. You do your lamp dick shit. And I'm going to be out here chilling, all
right? Right.
I'll be in the car.
Oh, my gosh.
But eventually, they start kissing after that. And even that shit looked awkward as fuck, at least in my opinion.
Yeah. It was,
I guess when you got, it's just a little floozy you don't care about, you just go for broke, I guess.
Right. Fuck you, bitch. Damn, my bad. I feel like I'm becoming so harsh on that. Look, I'm really not like that in person, okay?
Oh, my God.
It's just, yeah. I'm just not like that in person.
All right, man. What the fuck is, okay, yeah. So, they fuck all awkward and weird.
Mm-hmm.
He tells her,
get the door.
Fuck up. Well, that too.
I think, yeah.
Yeah, no. Did he actually say get the fuck out?
I think he said something like that.
Maybe he did. But if he didn't say it, he pretty much said get the fuck out.
Yeah, more or less.
So she gets the fuck out. Hey, I don't even have my clothes. Oh, here, open the door, throw them at her. There's your fucking clothes. Get the fuck out.
He said, I'll give you gas fare. Here, cab fare.
Like, oh, yeah, because she was like, you brought me here. What am I supposed to do? Like, here's $5. Call a cab. Phone book is out there in the booth.
Man, $5 must have been like 20 back then or some shit.
I mean, 86, maybe a little something.
Yeah, shit.
So she goes into the phone booth. She trying to make a call. Mm. Guess who comes? Oh, mama come.
Right?
Stab that ass.
Was there a reason for that, or was that just, she just had to kill somebody because fucking Marine got away?
Well, this is a slasher movie. We got to see some slashing.
There you go.
I don't know what the fucking reason was. Had his naked girl outside in the middle of the
it
night.
It happened.
Norma's dick got hard. Mama took over. Stabby, stabby. Hey, there's your kill count.
There you go. Stabby, stabby. Yeah. Not that stabby. Way.
Well, it was that way before.
Ah, yeah.
She got double penetrated.
Oh!
Jokes. We got them. Next morning, though, Duke wakes up. And he sees Norman Bates cleaning the phone booth, and he's looking like, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you cleaning the phone booth? Because there was blood there. But he doesn't tell him that. Maureen's talking to her counselor. Blah. Duke and Tracy talk again. Blah. Mm-hmm. Come to find out, homecoming game is happening this weekend, so the motel's actually full.
Right.
Tracy comes, tries to talk to Norman again. Norman tells her to hit what, PJ?
The door. Leave.
Basically tells her to get the fuck out.
All right.
Scares her off even because she shook when she walks away. Then right after that, he goes to start flirting with Maureen because she asked something about like her. She was like, oh, you clean my dresses. And he's like, oh, yeah, I cleaned all of them. I especially like that dress right there, though. And she's like, yeah. He like, yeah, you know, it would look real good on you tonight, girl.
Mm-hmm.
And she gives a little smile. It's like, hey, Norman got some pimping. You know, right? Okay, yes. You're smoother pimping. I see you. They go out for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
They're dancing on the dance floor.
Ooh, he got the moves, too.
Yeah.
My boy.
She like, oh, I feel silly. You know, people laughing in the background. And basically like, man, fuck them people, girl. It's me and you out here right now. Right. Don't worry about them. You see me.
Right.
I see you. We here.
That's all that matters.
Hey. They go back home. Maureen sees mother in the window. But she don't really say nothing about it. Because why? She trying to get some of that Norman dick.
Oh, yeah.
Hey. Pretty much, she's all up on you. She's all up on Norman, like, for real, though.
Literally.
Like, she's really wanting that shit. And he's backing up off of her because, you know, he got that mama complex in his head. You know, if he get too horny, it did get too hard, mama gonna come out and kill her ass. So he's trying to, you know, back up off of her. But eventually, she smooths him. Girlie got the game on him this time.
Right.
They don't have sex or nothing, though. But they end up just, like, laying together till they fall asleep.
Right.
But then she wakes up because some random ass, you know, motel visitor comes and shakes her and is like, hey, you know, you was asleep with the door open and it's a bunch of drunk motherfuckers out here, you know, you don't want to get nothing done to you, so I just want to let you know. Whereas where I would have just shut the fucking door. Right. I ain't gonna wake nobody up, though. That's one thing I hate is when people wake me up. That's why I don't wake other people up.
Bitch, why?
Right, unless I got to. Like I said, work nights. Don't come waking me up for no bullshit.
Right. Because
I fuck you. Verbal thrashing. Yeah. Can't get put in jail for assault for verbal thrashing.
There you go.
Pro tips.
Verbal thrashing.
From Home Video Hustle. Hey.
Hey.
Marine goes up to the house, though, where Norman is at. Norman's in there arguing with his mama, or himself, whatever.
Yeah, right.
And she's basically, she is trying again hard to get Norman to let her in that house. Like, come on, she's like, even, she's got, like, her hands, like, wrapped around the little post, all smiling, like it's, like, some kind of fucking Disney movie. Right. Norman, are you okay? He's like, I'm feeling sick. She's like, oh, let me come up there. I can help you. Just get,
right.
Just got the fishing reel, just, like, trying to reel that motherfucker in. Like, yeah. But Norman still tells her to fuck off. Get out of here. And he's fighting with the urge to kill her, I guess, from the mom, because he has the knife in his hand. And he clasps it, like, in his fist with the blade part going up against his knuckles.
Mm-hmm.
And punches a table. So, of course, the knife goes into his damn fingers, which I know hurt like a bitch.
Yeah, right?
So, eventually, she fucks off. But mama still got to get her kill in, though. So, the girlie that went and woke her up and told her about, hey, your door is open. She's in the parlor of the motel office. Taking a piss. For some reason, I don't know why she didn't go to
the
room.
Right?
I don't remember why.
She said, hey, you got a John in?
Huh? Yeah. So she goes and sits down on the toilet. Mama comes in from off camera and... gunshots. Mama comes in from off camera and girlie's like, hey, you know, occupied. Get up out of here.
Right, occupado.
Yeah. Come on, please. Occupado. Whatever the fuck she said. And then she gets her motherfucking throat slit.
Mm-hmm.
Blood everywhere. And she gets stabbed in the chest for efforts.
It's all bad.
Got to get them kills in, bro. 1986, bro. Jason and Freddy and Michael Myers are on that ass.
Mm.
You got to get your kill on.
Oh, there was a meme that said it had, fuck, who? Not Jason. Yeah, Freddy. No, Jason. One of the two niggas.
Jason got hockey mask. Freddy got burnt face. Michael Myers got the all white.
It was Mike.
It was Mike.
Okay. It was Michael Myers. They said a meme had... It, because you know the It just came out, and it had him and the mom, and it said, "There's too much clown shit going on, my son. You know what you have to do."
I was like, "Yeah, bring this guy back."
Oh, you said with the mom? Are you sure it's not Jason? Because Jason had the thing with his mom.
It might be Jason.
Because the hockey mask.
Yes. Yes.
That's what I said. Michael Myers got the all-white Captain Kirk Star Trek mask.
Oh, no. The hockey mask.
Oh, okay. Yes,
yeah. His mom said, you know what you have to do, son.
I was like, wait a minute. Hold on.
Ah, shit. Yeah, it was funny.
I ain't seen that one. I'm sure it'll start popping up. Always like the one dumbass. It's like it's a gif. It's not a meme, though. Where it's like the guy got the Jason mask on and he's like running through like the fall leaves, like dancing with the machete in his hand, and he just starts stabbing motherfuckers and shit. Like, oh,
I haven't seen it.
I think I posted that shit somewhere. I think the Final Girls posted up something like, what's your favorite like Halloween gift? And I think I posted that shit on their page. Hey, shout out to the Final Girls horror cast. Hey,
la 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 la, die bitch, die.
Pretty much. I gotta find that shit. But what the fuck was he talking about? Oh, yeah, girlie got stabbed up on the toilet, right?
Mm-hmm.
Norman comes and sees it. And he has to clean it up. Has the same exact reaction that he had when he saw Marion dead in the first movie. Yeah, you know, turn away, got them from the bathroom real quick, put the hand over the mouth, you know, iconic shit that they tried to redo.
Yeah.
It's not the same, though. So he goes to clean that shit up. Police come the next day and ask about, hey, where the fuck is this girl at, Norman?
Mm-hmm.
They search the house, and Norman is bugging out because no mother is upstairs.
Yes.
You can't see that shit.
He said, I want y'all to leave. He said, we have a warrant.
Yeah, he takes off up them stairs.
Mm-hmm.
They follow him, but then everybody's shocked because there's nothing there.
Yeah. And
Norman is even more shocked than anybody.
Right? Where's mother? Mother?
Mama!
Mother?
Mama!
Where is he? There's a note left.
Oh, we ain't got to the note yet.
Uh-oh.
Slightly. I got to bring up something because I think it grossed you out and it made me laugh.
Was it?
Cops are done investigating. They come down there and tell Norman because it's Norman, Duke... Tracy, the reporter, and Marine, they're down. And he's sitting on like the icebox, and they're talking. Tracy's mad because they're like, "What do you mean you ain't find nothing? You know, there had to be something up there." Sheriff is grabbing ice out the joint. Mm-hmm. But see, earlier after he killed the girl on the toilet, he couldn't hide the body because all those motherfuckers were running around. So he threw in the icebox. So he's reaching in there, but doesn't see that this girl's head and fingers and shit are poking out. And there's a big ass spot in there where the ice has blood on it.
Yes.
He grabs in there once, gets some ice, chews on it or whatever. Grabs in there a second time, it's all good. Grabs that third time, grabs that bloody ice.
Blood.
puts it in his mouth and then licks like his fingers and everything.
Yes.
Just eating the evidence.
That man.
And I looked over at PJ, this motherfucker looked like he was about to earl.
It made me want to. I could only, oh my gosh, that's nasty.
Blah, 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 blah.
So nasty.
I thought it was funny. I always laughed at that one.
Blooded in my dictionary.
Oh, hell.
Who's that, James?
That's Rick James.
Rick James, yeah.
Rick James, bitch. Mm. And that's when he finds the note. It says, hey, you know, I'm in room 12. Come holler at me, mother. And it's signed mother. So he's like, what the fuck is this? Go to that room. Come to find out, Duke hid the body.
Yes.
And he's basically trying to extort Norman now. Like, hey, I could have told the cops, but I didn't.
Right.
And, you know, Norman's like, I ain't got no money, bro. And Duke's like, shit, man, you got all this, you know, land.
Land. Sell an acre.
Yeah, he's like, man, you can just sell me an acre.
Mm-hmm.
And pay me on that. And Norman basically is like, nah, homie. Blow. Hits that motherfucker with an ashtray right in his forehead.
And he hopped up quick as shit, because I know ashtrays, and them shits are heavy.
Uh-huh.
But he hopped up, tried to fight him.
That motherfucker was pissed. They got into a little scuffle, though.
Yeah, somehow Norman's scrawny-assed and fucking choked his ass out.
Yep. Then once he had him on the ground, your man's picked up his guitar and started smashing his ass with it. Like, repeatedly, he Jeff Jarrett'd the shit out of him. You don't know what that means.
No, I do not.
There's a wrestler. His name was Jeff Jarrett. You know what his gimmick was?
A guitar.
Smashing people in the head with guitars.
Ah, whoa.
And there was a time where it went wrong. I just watched this recently on the WWE Network. Hey, if you like wrestling, you probably should go watch that shit. I ain't getting paid for that, but I'm going to tell you anyway. But there's another wrestler named X-Pac. Mm-hmm. I don't remember if it was Raw or SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
He hit the motherfucker with the guitar. Didn't go quite right. Split that motherfucker's face. Cut him, because the wood splinters cut him up.
Oh.
And then even newer shit. It's a wrestler named Elias Sampson. He does pretty much the same type of gimmick. There's another wrestler named Finn Balor. He went to hit Finn Balor with the guitar. It didn't quite hit right, and he ended up fucking homeboy up with that guitar. And I don't think he's done that since then.
Oh, damn, see?
So, yeah. Damn, if you want to see somebody actually get hit with a guitar, watch WWE. Damn, or F, damn. Whatever.
Or F.
Hey.
One of them.
It's always WWF to me, damn it. That's when I grew up. Shit. Old school. Pimping.
Right. Fuck your new school.
Exactly. Damn Agnes. Pandas. Yeah, damn Panda Agnes. Making them change the name. While all that's happening, Tracy finds out about, you know, there was a previous owner of the diner that knew all about Spool.
Yeah.
But he's, you know, not in the nut house, but he's like in a, you know, retirement home. Because, you know, he's old and his mind ain't all there no more. Goes to talk to him and finds out some shit about Miss Spool. And he finds out that she was in an asylum at some point. And it's like, oh, her ass was crazy too, huh?
Right. So is that why in the second one she came in on some I'm your mother type shit?
Yes, sir. Basically explained that away. Yeah.
Okay.
So old girl Marina is talking to her shrink. She basically tells the shrink, like, I'm done fucking with you. I'm about to go hang out with Norman. You know, he understands me.
Mm-hmm.
He can love me. He can treat me the way I'm supposed to be treated and all that.
It must have been a sign.
She thought there you go.
Since he had his mom's little get up on, she thought it was a sign that it was Mary.
Yeah. When she was bleeding out in the tub and she looked up and saw Norman dressed up as mother, she didn't see that. She saw Mary with light behind her.
Yeah.
And she, instead of the knife, she saw like a shiny silver crucifix.
Mm-hmm.
So she was gone in the head too, but she was leaking in a motherfucking bathtub, right. So it's understandable.
Right.
So she's about to run back home to Norman. Norman, at the same time, is wrapping up all these fucking bodies and taking them to the swamp.
Yeah.
As he's driving to the swamp, Duke ain't dead. Duke
pops up.
Yeah, he pops up and tries to choke him out from the back seat.
Mm-hmm.
Norman, I think, somehow like pulls him toward the front, and he has his head like near the gas pedal, and he's basically like using his foot. He's got his foot on his throat, and he's holding him down. But all that's happening, the motherfucker accidentally drives into the swamp.
Right.
So now, to make things even worse for old boy Duke down there, He's getting a foot up on his throat, and now he's drowning.
Drowning, yeah, right?
Because Norman Bates opened up the window, and all the water came in. So Duke is dead as fuck.
Right, that's all bad.
So Norman Bates is swimming out, and all the dead bodies are, like, floating around, and he's down there screaming, all these dead people down here, and all these fucking, like, vehicles he done threw down there.
Right.
But he gets up out of there and heads back home. When he gets back home, no, he's in there. I think he's like going at it with mama again.
Mm-hmm.
Marine comes home and is like looking for Norman. And is basically like trying to be like, look, I'm down for you. You know, let's do the damn thing.
Right. Fuck what everybody else says.
They're upstairs talking and she's kind of getting through to him. Mother says something
And she calls him.
Yeah.
Norman?
Norman or something. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Norman like turns real fast or something. Like kind of, I think he bumped old girl at the mm-hmm. top of the steps. And she falls in almost the same type of way that Arbogast fell in the first movie. Even though the first movie came out in 1960, this is from 1986. And it looked way better in the first movie from the fucking 60s.
Yeah.
It looked so goofy in this movie. Because it was almost like when she got to the bottom, she was like, it was like magnetized. Like her neck just like, like went right up against the fucking spike.
Right. Because
there's like a statue or something. It's
Cupid.
Got like, it's a Cupid statue. Oh, there you go.
Yeah. See what they did there.
Filmmaking. You see, she gets her neck pushed up against the pointy end. It goes through and kills her ass.
Mm-hmm.
Marine is dead as fuck.
There you go.
And Norman Bates is pissed. Mother!
Yes.
You know, gets his yell on.
Yes.
While Norman and Mother are yelling at each other, Tracy steps in.
Mm-hmm.
She's looking around. She hears them upstairs arguing. And she sees Marine, like, in the time between Tracy getting there and her getting fucking murdered, he put Marine, like, on the couch with, like, candles and shit. Made, like, basically, like, some kind of little shrine. And Tracy sees that shit. She hears a voice behind her. Turn around, and it's Norman Bates and full Mother get up and talking in the Mother voice, mm-hmm. which is fucking hilarious. And so Tracy, of course, is trying to run away, and she's trying to talk sense into him at the same time. That motherfucker's gone.
Right.
They go upstairs. She finds the fucking mother's body, and she's telling him all this stuff. Like, you know, Spool wasn't really your mother. She was crazy. She was trying to, like, fuck over your mother by, like, taking your dad from her and all this other shit like that. And it starts to get through to Norman because he starts taking off the wig and the dress and all that shit. Puts the knife up. Think he's going to kill Tracy, but no, he stabs Mother.
Yes.
Mother's like, what the fuck are you doing? And he keeps stabbing her. And eventually he says something like, yeah, I ain't got the guts, huh? Decapitates Mama's ass.
Nothing but sand coming out the neck.
Then you cut to outside. Police got Norman in handcuffs. Sheriff is telling him, like, you fucking dumbass, I had your back.
Right.
You out here doing this dumb shit.
Right.
Norman Bates don't care, though, because he's like, yo, I'm free, though, fam. I'm good now.
Fuck that house. Fuck everything that was with it.
Yeah, and Mother, mother dead. I'm going back to the nut house. Everything about to be fly.
Shit.
And but as they're riding to the fucking nut house or wherever the hell he about to go, Norman Bates pulls a fucking, like, severed arm from Mother from out of his fucking shirt sleeve.
Yes.
He's rubbing on it like it's a cat. And then he looks up at the camera almost like he does at the end of the original movie.
Yes.
The whole, the, you know, the background, everything fades to black. All you see is like the side of his face smiling, this little weird creepy ass smile. And then that's Psycho 3.
There you go.
Booyah. Kind of blazed through that one somewhat.
Yeah, I was about to say, that was good.
Yeah, I mean, it's not really
too much to explain.
A whole lot, yeah. I mean,
it's just killing.
Last couple movies for real just been kind of just like whatever type genre. Demolition Man, just action movie.
Yeah.
Psycho 3 is a little slasher movie.
Mm.
A little something.
What you expect, yeah.
So slim.
Yes.
What did you think about Psycho 3?
Psycho 3.
You said something that scared me earlier.
Yeah.
You said after the movie was over, you might like this one better than others. And I was like, no shit. He about to piss some people off. So that's
no, I don't. Oh. I like it better than two.
What?
I don't like it better than one.
You still out your damn mind. I love two way more. Two is way better.
I don't know.
Really?
Maybe because I haven't seen two in a minute, but it's like, I know. From what I remember, I just like this one better.
From what you remember, what do you like more about this movie than Psycho 2? I'm very fucking curious about that.
I feel like two was more about the plot of trying to get him.
Right.
You know, thrown it. Oh. Trying to. Yeah, right? That's my youngest son.
Yeah, we at PJ's house recording this for the second week in a row.
Yeah, right? I think I just like that the plot is back on Norman.
It's and not so Norman. Much. It's not somebody else doing shit.
Yeah, trying to make it seem like Norman. Like, this is Norman.
That's
all
I like about the second movie, though, because it's kind of like it's like, you don't know that shit, though, until the end. It's like, you know, it's like a little twisty twist at the end, kind of.
Like, gotcha.
Yeah, like, gotcha, motherfucker.
Yeah.
I don't know, and I think the storyline and everything was better in the second one. I just like the second one as a whole better than the third one, in my opinion. The
second one as a whole.
Yeah, I like everything about the second one better. I like this one, but I just like the second one way better.
I mean, for real, that's the only thing that I like. That's why I like it more. But what? It's still, they're all bomb-ass movies. Like,
okay.
They're all for me, I wish we could do 8.5s.
Oh, really? That high? Huh?
I got to go with the 8 cuz it's not it's not a 9, you know, it's an 8 is, but it's definitely, I liked it. I enjoyed it.
Hey, that's real, pal. If you like
it had
this
the
shit.
Slasher qualities all the way through. So, okay. Yeah. And as for you,
it's not an 8. Uh-oh. I'll tell you that. I don't, like I said, of the 4 Psycho movies, they all kind of, they go downward for me as they go on. Because the first one is, of course, the best one.
Mm-hmm.
Second one is very fucking close, but it's not as good as the first one. This one is not as good as the second one or the first one, in my opinion. And if we ever get to the fourth one, I don't like that one as much as any of the other 3.
Mm.
So they go downward in quality, in my opinion. But I do still like all of them. Except the Psycho remake. That was just a waste of time, in my opinion. But I know why they made it. But... okay, I got to talk. Okay. Let's get into some shit here.
Oh,
I got something to say about something.
Oh, shit.
You know what? I'm going to give my score first before I get into all mm-hmm. that. Like I said, I don't like this movie as much as the first two. It's all right, though. If I was going to do anything, I'd be like, is it a 6 or a 7? Like 6.5 or something. Don't do 0.5s here. So I'm going to give it a 6.
Okay. A 6?
Yeah.
Wow. That's like a tad bit above average.
Yeah, I mean, it's all right. It's cool.
Okay.
Just the other two are just like, in my opinion, so much fucking higher quality, though.
Because he directed this one?
No, I ain't got no problem with the direction. Mm-hmm. It's just like, just storyline, everything. It's just, it's a lot of goofy shit in this movie, too.
Yeah. Yes. You gonna? All right. Sorry, real quick. Hey, guys. Welcome to the family. It's family time, real quick.
The family hustle.
Hey, come say something to the mic, real quick.
Yeah.
You gonna wanna talk? I thought we had another guest appearance, but y'all heard the cry, and I guess that was good enough today.
What do you think about Psycho 3, Shayla? You saw bits of it.
Yeah, it was okay.
Oh. She's more in line with you. Yeah, she's in line with...
Okay. The first one was better, was the best, of course.
Wow.
It is the best.
There you go.
It's the best. I haven't seen the second one. So.
I'm gonna leave them here. You can just watch them.
Yes.
It's 2, 3, 2, 3,
Brett's
and 4 right
clutch
there.
With the movies.
Always.
Hey. Always.
I hope y'all heard that on the microphone. That's a quote for a T-shirt.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Right.
So what were you about to say? What was your?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I got a problem with you young whippersnappers. I got a big ass issue with y'all young people. Y'all other young people.
Okay. Okay. People who are younger than 26.
Exactly. There you go, you young motherfucker. Because I know people our age that still have this problem. That's what I'm saying. You young people that don't know no better.
Mm-hmm.
If I try to show you Psycho, and you tell me, mm-hmm. if I try to show you Psycho, Frankenstein, mm-hmm. Dracula, Night of the Living Dead, you know, can y'all see the theme I'm going with here? Y'all know what I'm about
theme.
To say, right?
I see the theme.
I try to show you any of those movies,
mm-hmm.
and you say, oh, but it's in black and white.
Mm.
Guess what?
Mm.
Fuck you.
The door.
No, it ain't even the door that time. Just straight fucking.
No.
And then.
The door.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. It's a common thing. I keep hearing that. Like, oh, I don't want to watch it. It's in black and white. Is that really such a big issue? Does that bother you, PJ?
It did when I first started getting, you know, into the whole movie thing. Because it's just, it's not my time period, you know? So it was hard for me to adjust to all black and white. Like, damn, I want to see some fucking color. I want to see this vividly. But after... like Psycho. Yeah. Psycho, that movie. Like, you know, you don't even... it's such a good movie. Fuck the black and white.
Exactly.
You know, you catch on to the storyline and the plot. So, but yeah, I mean, I see where they're coming from, but...
no.
Fuck it.
No.
Like, you know, just get into the movie. Fuck the black and white.
Fuck you young kids.
Huh.
You can't watch black and white movies. Taylor, what you think about black and white movies? Do you got Hit the Door too?
I can take some black and white movies, for real.
Uh-huh.
Some of them I can do.
Okay. You like Psycho, right?
I love Psycho because I like Norman Bates, though. Like he's a really great.
You saw the TV show.
He's a really great guy. Yeah. Okay.
I did. I saw the TV show, Bates Motel.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm a proud fan of that.
Me too. I'm with you.
I watched beginning to end. Yep, I'm all the way caught up, and I'm ready for the next season.
It's not coming back. It's over.
What?
Yeah, you didn't know that.
Damn.
Oh, she got crushed on my
girl. I'm just telling you.
Yeah,
about
she
that.
Was. She was just hyped for that shit.
PJ, guess what? You got revenge.
Yeah, right? You can leave it in there now.
Hey, I can leave it in there. Yeah, that shit, it ended,
I'm
though.
I'm sorry. That was my shit,
well,
bro.
It ended, like, maybe a couple months back. It's
but
not recently. No, the whole new season that came out. It was like season 5 came out. Yeah, yeah.
Damn.
Oh, man.
Yeah, how do you feel now?
Sad. I guess I gotta watch Psycho. They better come out with a new one.
Did you see the last season, though?
Yeah, I saw the last season.
Oh, yeah, she saw. She was.
How you didn't know it ended? Because Summer Bates died at the end of it.
Who died?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
I watched the season before.
Oh, damn.
Damn.
I thought.
The last thing I saw was when he had unburied his mom.
Oh, you missed
back.
The whole last season.
See, I, damn.
Damn.
What? Well, I didn't tell you how. Well, you still gotta see how.
You didn't tell me how. I still gotta see how and who, and I'm pretty sure he killed himself.
Who, what, when, where, how?
I know he did. He's crazy. I know Norman. We're friends. We were really good friends. Oh, my
God. Is PJ Norman?
That scares me.
Are you Norman? Are you gonna eat this, P? No. Wasting stuff.
You get to see all of PJ's life.
Right, now, right. Period. Like, I'm working now, babe.
Sorry.
Fuck.
Sorry.
We are professionals, damn.
Damn.
I'm leaving all this in there.
Right? People listen to this.
No joke. Shayla, we got over 1,000 downloads.
I know. I hear it every time. I always ask how you guys are doing.
Hey, let's find out live on the mic.
Yeah, right.
I'm going to tell you exactly what the number at.
Hey, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, scroll the fuck down.
All right. Thank you.
1,060 total downloads.
Oh, boy.
That's actually way more than it was last time I looked.
All right. 1,060. 22 weeks.
In just the last 3 months.
Pops.
854.
And you know, a lot of stuff is going on right now. I really don't understand.
What's that?
Dad.
Oh, shit.
No, yeah.
You want to do that on the microphone?
No, I don't. That's not coming on the microphone.
I would edit the fuck out of that anyway. just because he don't like me. So you don't get to be on the show, Pops.
Sorry.
That is the funniest guy I've ever met.
Funny story. So, you know me and Brent go back. Well, you've heard all those stories.
Yeah.
When he first started coming over the house.
Oh, you going that far back?
Yeah. So, you know, my pops believed in education. Education is the way. Knowledge is the way.
Oh,
fuck
God.
Everything else.
Hey, my pops is the same way.
If it's,
that's why me and him had beef for 10 years.
Yeah, right.
That's a story. For
that's
me,
a story.
That's a rather depressing one, though.
I mean, this one is. Yeah, this. This one isn't as depressing.
Yeah, this one's
long cool. Story short, every weekend he was staying over my house, or I would go over his house.
Yeah, we had to alternate. Nice, he couldn't come out the house unless I went to their house.
We had
to alternate. We was fucking separated like kids.
Because no lie, for the first, I would say,
first
from
months,
September,
right?
All the way until winter break, I was not at home.
Out here.
Like, fuck that shit. I'm going over his house.
Dad finally got hip to it.
Yeah, and he said, nah, y'all went to switch. But when he was there, he would make... I had to read fucking...
You had to read news articles.
Yeah, I had to read news articles.
And they write about
US,
it, right?
Yes.
Summarize it.
Yeah, summarize articles. And they were all about...
Oh, you ever heard this?
I did.
Oh, okay.
You know, it was about money. It was about, you know, and anything. Any and everything that could help.
Remind them who your dad was. He's not just... I mean, what did he do for a living, PJ?
I said he was a teacher.
Not
he was an educator.
He was an honors high school teacher.
Mm.
That's pretty big for real. Like, that's not just a regular teacher. Like, he's an honors teacher. You know what I'm saying?
No,
principals of school.
He was a principal of some schools in Cleveland.
Okay, so he's going to hold you to a certain standard.
I'm his son.
You ain't got no choice.
He said what?
Yeah, right. That's what it led me to. He tried to get Brent.
Oh yeah, try being the key word.
To fucking read
try
some shit.
The key word.
This nigga went downstairs and said, "Fuck it, I'm not doing shit. Text me when you're done, and I'll come back up." He went downstairs because he would bring his Xbox over. So while I was upstairs, of course I was in the trap. This guy would be downstairs playing. Who knows what? Fucking
Halo.
Grand Theft Auto? Grand Theft Auto was
true
hot
crime.
There. And I would hear the shit through the vents. And I would be so fucking salty. Like, man.
I get to go home, fam. Fuck that
right.
No, but no joke. There will be times where if I didn't do that shit, or if I didn't, like, converse with him in the way he wanted me to,
mm-hmm.
he would call my parents.
Yes.
And try and rat me out.
Yes.
And luckily, my parents would tell him basically to
fuck off.
Fuck off,
yeah. Like, hey, who cares?
I didn't know your parents, right? I didn't know that.
But it would be to talk about, like, be to talk about education and, like, the OGT
why I didn't go to
testing.
Yeah.
Yeah, random shit. Just trying to talk him into.
I was just curious why Britt didn't go to a real college. Like, first of all, motherfucker, I went to a real college.
Right.
Suck my dick from the back. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said, I'm sorry, that's your possible.
That's a little.
I apologize. I'm used to talking shit about people. I forgot your. I'm sorry. I apologize.
It's okay. But yeah.
Yes, you get to how I feel.
Yeah. And no lie, from that winter all the way up until I graduated, that's how it was. Anytime he would come over, He would basically, that's why I was like, he was really like my brother. Like, it would be like, he, like, nah, I ain't doing that shit. Ain't like fuck him, that. Buddy. Like, I'm going downstairs. I'm still here, but I'm just downstairs.
I'm with you, fam. But I ain't with you on that.
Yeah. Oh, y'all about to leave? All right, let's go. Where we going? Shit.
To church? Nah, I'm just
yeah. Like, I'm gonna stay home. I'm gonna stay home.
Every time too, they'd be like, PJ, be like, we going to church. I'm like, all
right,
I'm going to sleep.
I mean, yeah, right.
Go back to sleep,
my and we would be up until fucking 6-7 o'clock in the morning,
watching Pulp Fiction and Natural Born Killers,
Reservoir Dogs, anything. Yeah, man.
Quentin Tarantino weekends, RoboCop.
Fuck.
The good old days, man.
Good times. Good times. Fucking Ricky Harris.
Yes,
that was the Jeff shit.
Comedy Jam, man.
Yeah, man.
Find Def Comedy Jam All-Stars Volume 1, damn it. It's like $3.99 on Amazon. I've had two copies. That was because one of them got stolen.
Oh, damn.
Shit.
Damn.
It's one of those things. It's one of those things, you let somebody borrow something, you don't get it back. Basically got stolen. I still ain't got my copy of How High from middle school. Chris, if you listening.
Hey.
Not cousin Chris, friend Chris. No, I'm still missing that.
Oh. Damn.
Now, if it was cousin Chris, I know where the fuck he'd live at. So I can go get my shit.
Get that shit.
Chris is in the army.
Damn.
So he might even shoot my ass if I step to him.
Oh, he's still alive?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
He's had a kid.
He said he's in the army.
Well, you know, shit.
But he's in the army.
There's a lot of people that are in the army that you just don't know right now.
That's true.
Fuck.
Especially with the old fuck-ass president we got right now.
You know what? If you voted, ha! Did you tell him? We didn't tell him.
Oh, what happened? What did we do?
In Cincinnati.
We didn't tell that story.
No,
we didn't.
So
you want to tell it?
I told you. You about to find out.
I'll let PJ tell it because he loves this shit.
Yes, it brought me so much joy, and it, from the bottom of my soul. For one, sorry to say, but because they were white people who were saying it, and for two. Because I've never heard anybody in real life that I don't know say this shit. So.
I just saying like in real life out loud.
Yeah, like in real life out loud. I have never, but it brought me so much joy. Like oh my gosh. We were walking. We were.
It's got the build up. You got to build it up, Shay.
I'm sorry.
We were coming from the spot with.
We were coming from the bar with Hobie from, and 365.
Yes. Great times. Hey, great times.
Shout out again.
And yes. Thanks for an amazing night, guys. We were walking back downtown. All of a sudden.
Drop one of Clues bomb.
Drop
one. Sound drops.
Yeah, drop one of Clues bombs for them. Okay, so we were walking back, you know, a little bit pissy.
Oh, curious.
Yes.
Who knows what the fuck that means that's listening to this? Hit me up on Twitter.
Right. There gotta be somebody.
Somebody that listens to The Breakfast Club.
Right.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, you're good, you're good. We was walking back a little pissy.
We were pissed, right?
Yeah, we were pissed, a little pissy. And,
New words, man.
Yeah, right? Learned that word that night. If you don't know what it means.
Pissy drunk?
Pissed, yeah.
Pissed. No, but he said, I'm pissed. Like, that's what he said, I'm pissed right now. And I was like, yeah, he was from Britain. I was like, you're pissed? Like, you're mad? He was like, no, I'm pissed.
I'm drunk.
I was like, yeah. I was like, oh, that's exactly what I...
Pissy drunk. Because people, I've heard people...
Yeah, babe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what he meant.
But why are you acting like you didn't know this?
Well, because what he said,
he
pissed.
Said, I'm pissed.
I'm pissed. He didn't sound
like
pissy.
He didn't say I'm pissy. He said I'm pissed.
And PJ thought he was like mad.
Yeah, I was like, what's wrong? Like, what are you mad about? He said, I'm pissed. I was like, okay, like pissy drunk. Yeah, it's like, oh, okay. But anyways, we was walking back.
He's taking a while.
Pissed. Yeah, and there was what, a guy and a girl.
Yeah.
And they had to be pissed too, because. They were on some...
They were pissed in both ways.
Yeah, literally. And it was, fuck Donald Trump. Fuck any white supremacists who voted for Trump.
Yeah.
Fuck every... And we were walking, and there was two old white couple.
God damn.
Sorry, but you could tell that they voted for Trump.
No, I was
going to
say, it wasn't two couples. It was a couple.
It was a old white couple. And you could tell they voted for Trump.
Because
they stopped in their tracks.
Man.
Turned around.
Thought it was
y'all.
I think they might have thought it was. Because we were laughing.
Right.
And we both yelled it back. Like, yeah, fuck
Donald Trump. Damn right. Fuck him.
At the top of our lungs.
Yes. But the reaction on their face was priceless. Like, you could tell they voted for him, but at the same time, they didn't say anything. Yeah, right. Oh my gosh. Yes. That was.
It was so much fun.
Yeah, that was fun.
It was fun as fuck down there.
Got lost in downtown.
They can make a black psycho.
Blacko? Like, that was a good idea. There probably is a black psycho somewhere. There's Blackenstein. There was Blackula. There's Dr. Black and Mr. Hyde. Nuh-uh. I'm dead. I'm not joking.
There was Bruce Leroy.
The Last Dragon.
There you go.
Yeah, The Last Dragon. Yeah, that's a real movie. We got to do that. I got to get that movie one day.
Bruce Leroy? Fuck yeah. That's my shit.
I got to get that.
Yeah, that was that. I just wanted to say that made my night and made me really happy, you know, that a white person said, fuck Donald Trump. And, you know, I'm not trying to be...
A lot of them say that shit, though.
Yeah, I know. But it's
everybody in our little tour crew said that shit.
Yeah, you know, but I've never heard it...
In person.
That's like being called... I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah.
But that's like being called a nigga in person for the first time. Like, you know, it really resonates with you. The first time I got called a nigga by a... Or... I don't know how that would feel because I'm not white.
Very true.
So...
But I'm sure they don't like that.
No, they don't.
They don't.
Okay, you know,
I see what you're saying. Yes.
From both parties.
Yes. Well... Apparently, we have another guest on the show
she
today.
She might be going to sit down.
Yeah, right? Take a sweet.
She's been here for like the last 20 minutes. Mm.
I was cleaning.
It's all good. I'm good.
All right, the review's out the way. My bad.
Yeah, we the movie done. After the movie, we talked for like 20 minutes, but we've been going for like almost a half hour now.
So. Yeah, we still ain't hit the mark yet.
I don't give a man. It's all good. Yeah. People like, usually like this shit more than the movie talking. Yeah,
just talking shit.
Okay.
Hold on. Since she's here, why don't you tell the good people
who I am? And what I do?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to turn the mic slightly towards you, though, because you said it don't pop you.
Hello. Ooh. This is Shayla M.
Is she still
on the mic?
Yeah. She stole her gimmick without knowing her gimmick.
Wow.
This is Polly P's girl. Oh. From the east side.
Ooh.
Okay. I'm just here to, you know, vibe out. Mm-hmm. Hear these comments and reviews. Give you a little bit of input.
Oh, my God.
A little
she
insight.
She fits right into what?
So y'all know this was not rehearsed.
No,
like, she hasn't heard the end of this shit.
That's because this is fun, guys. I've been watching them do this for a while, and this is a lot of fun.
It really is, yeah.
So, hi.
There you go. Okay.
She got super hyped there. That's what I'm saying. She feels even the hypeness.
I'm even excited.
Any other things?
So how about those calves now?
Yeah, right?
Oh, we got Wade.
Yeah, we did.
What happened?
We got Dwayne Wade.
He said his dream is still, though,
to I was like, what the fuck are you talking about?
With the Miami Heat.
I was just joking. I don't know shit about basketball.
About the Cavs.
The Cavs have Dwayne.
Mm. Oh, do they? Does that mean LeBron leaving?
No, LeBron
is there on the team.
Oh, so yes. It's going to be Miami shit over again.
He said it's like walking into the classroom on the first day of class and find out
your best
friend's
in there. Yeah,
but yeah,
saw that?
Yeah. I keep up, even though I don't watch the shit.
This reminded me of something, too. Right. Back in the days, when Pete Davis always trying to separate us all the time in school.
Yeah, man.
That shit never worked.
For nobody, though.
No. Me and Pete just yell across the room.
Yeah, I was about to say, people usually just yell across
the room. We told the story on the podcast before where it didn't matter if we was next to each other or not. If anybody started doing the top billing beat, we just started fucking rapping.
What's the top billing beat?
50 cents, I get money.
No, don't you fucking dare.
That's what she knows. That's
you do it, man.
What?
Don't teach them the new shit. Teach them the real shit.
He stole that from
I'm about to play. I'm about to play. Hold on.
Yeah, that song. Yeah. That he stole that. But that was hot when we were in 10th grade.
Yeah.
So people would start.
How do you do it?
Oh, you don't do that, please.
No.
Do my house in the microphone. Oh. Just be right here. Oh, you bastard.
Damn.
I forgot there was a video for
that. Yeah, right?
I remember
when
you
first showed me this video.
Who called Audio 2?
Yeah.
Low motherfucker.
You know what we should do for him?
What's that?
You heard Brent's poems.
Ooh.
But
oh, yeah,
I don't think he told y'all we have a rap book.
Oh, please don't make me bring that out.
From 10th grade.
We do not need to bring
before
that out.
I wanted to be a rapper.
We do not.
I haven't even heard this.
Because there's a reason.
Yeah.
Nobody has except me and him.
Yes.
Why?
Because it's fucking
bad.
Terrible.
That's
it
amazing.
Is so
and
bad.
It's from a time where
where
I was lightweight gone in the mind,
yes,
too. So it's a lot of violent shit in
yes
there. That
yes, it is.
Yeah, I talk about killing motherfuckers on there, mm-hmm, so I really don't want to bring that shit.
Well, the one you had a reason for, Taco Boy. You had
Oh, fuck that.
That was it. Yeah, you
and
had a reason
that
for that.
Fuck that girl I wrote it about, too.
Yeah. Yeah, bitch, fuck you.
I love that you got... Yeah, fuck you.
Damn right.
Hey, look, earlier in the show, we said some shit that we thought would piss women off. We said that and Shayla with us, so fuck everything.
Damn right.
Yeah. We leaving it in now.
Damn.
What did you guys say?
Just some shit.
Wait a second.
I don't know. I don't even remember no more. It was like an hour and a half ago.
Yeah, right?
It's going to be a long episode. And because I'm waiting for this fucking song to load. It will not load.
I think we've even quoted this shit.
We've sung it on the show.
Yeah.
We sung it in the reanimator review. Yeah. That's when we started the shit. Because we started doing the beat and we rapped it just like back in the day.
All right.
That's so funny. I want to get this rap book. Y'all still got it?
I sat in my house. It's almost like, you ever seen Indiana Jones? Mm-hmm. How the fuck is she sending you having PJ?
Look, you've never seen Indiana Jones?
Thank you. You've seen Die Hard? No, all right, forget y'all then. All right, you seen any Batman movies?
I've seen one, but I cannot tell you what it was, and I could not get into it.
Oh. I know PJ only seen one because we went to the movies and saw it. What about James Bond? You seen 007 movie?
I've seen parts of one and I couldn't get into it.
Oh, the door. See? You get the door, man.
The door.
That's some of my favorite movies.
The door.
You get the door.
Nah, I don't get the door. I get the door.
Yeah, you get the door.
The door.
The door.
What else? What else ain't P seen? You seen you see Friday the 13th. You seen Jason, haven't you?
Yeah, I love those.
He ain't never seen that.
Look.
I'm getting your ass in trouble, bro.
I'm a scary movie person.
Never seen Freddy Krueger either.
That's the whole point of them two.
Yeah.
You gotta know both of them.
See, give me
the way that works into my story. That's a huge story plot line. Like, that is like one of the best storylines to me. Freddy and Jason. I think that was so creative how they did that. I think that was just really cool how they did that.
Freddy the 13th, and guess who's playing Jason? I hate.
What was that?
Fucking Nicki Minaj.
Oh. I didn't even know what the hell that was.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Pauly P knows Nicki Minaj.
No. No, I do not.
Is it because of you?
It might be.
What?
No, that was before I even met her. That was like my freshman year in college, so that was no.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck they talking about. I'm completely out the loop here.
Yeah,
good. Hey, can't bring me down.
Can't be phased.
Did you know Cardi B made
number one on the Billboard? You know what?
The second to Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill was the first in 1996, and now she.
That's true.
No, she's first. She beat her, but she was the.
No, she's not first.
Oh, was she beat Lauryn Hill?
Yes.
No, she did not beat Lauryn Hill.
Oh, talk about
Lauryn Hill will never be beat.
Oh, okay.
You know he's obsessed with her.
Not.
Is he? Okay. Controversy.
Don't say it, because I know you fucking... All right, let's go.
Bring this shit.
Let's go.
I have heard the Miseducation Lauryn Hill album many times as a youngin', because my mom loves that CD. Guess what?
You don't like it.
I don't. It's I.
Do you?
It's look, okay.
This wait, is because wait, this well, man, he doesn't have a soul, okay? Like, he doesn't understand.
The truth.
Lauryn Hill speaks to the soul.
How?
Like, any of her songs.
Don't you? Is it because I just never got into it. Is it too girly? Or like,
no,
it's not girly.
It's not girly. I know,
it's
but
not
some
girly.
People,
I thought that, honestly. But
I know, I just, that's why I think.
I used to think that when I was younger, but when I got older and I even tried to listen, I just, I'm, eh. It's all right. I ain't gonna buy it. It's
it all could right. all be so simple, but you rather make
be
it
so
hard.
Simple.
I know the Wu-Tang version of that one. I fuck with the Wu-Tang. Can't be all so simple.
Yeah.
See.
Or.
And or the original
like
version.
Zion. Like.
Nah, I know that song, man.
Yeah. So you don't have a kid yet.
Yeah,
so
I don't
it
have
really
children.
Don't. Yeah. But that song. I cried, actually, when, like, the first time I heard that song after Felix was born, I was like, oh, shit. Like, it got
my baby.
I cried.
Oh, PJ getting brownie points now.
No, I was serious. I really
I
cried.
I believe you.
Like, okay, damn.
That's bad, too.
But, yeah, Lauryn Hill is, like... She is my.
She's so.
I would do anything to meet Lauryn Hill.
I'm trying to get him some tickets for real. I'm really trying.
Is she still doing anything?
Yeah, yes. She's on tour with Nas right now.
Why? Oh, okay, never mind.
Why would they be on tour together? You know why.
Yeah, I thought about it.
Damn.
I don't know why.
Because they had that song together, yeah, but then they're also the same. Like they're on the same
wavelength.
Yeah, with the. His bars and her singing, like
okay.
They're on the same.
Okay, I get what you're saying.
The new Fugees.
Yeah.
Ha, 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 ha.
Controversy.
Oh, shit.
I never care much for the Fugees.
Fuck!
Oh, my God.
Back when they were what were they before they were...
Refugee
they were,
camp.
No, they were called the Translocators.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
No, see?
One, two, three.
Your crew is called BDP. No. I'm singing the KRS-One version. See y'all.
Now, who came first? Probably KRS-One. Yeah.
Don't you dare.
Damn.
Nah, the Fugees. I never got into the Fugees. I got the Score album. I thought it was boring.
The one before that is one they really. I feel like the Score
might be slightly more.
It's more a Tribe Called Quest meets like De La Soul.
That's what I'm down for. What I thought the Score would be.
Nah, that's not. That's more. I feel like the Score is more Wyclef just trying.
That's exactly what the fuck it was, and I was like, I don't want to hear this shit. That motherfucker singing on his damn guitar, smash that shit like Animal House. You don't know what I mean, do you?
No.
Smash that shit like the shovel on the old girl's head and sound like Tootie, motherfucker. There you go. References.
Mm-hmm.
References.
Catch him.
Nah, but I like the Fuji Law song. Mm-hmm. I like the How Many. I basically like the singles, except.
Many.
And I'm about to controversy again on their ass. The Killing Me Softly, I don't like that song anymore.
Tangent. So.
Music battle.
Yeah, right? I didn't know at first that was a cover for a song.
Yeah, you didn't know that?
But then after I heard the cover, I still like Lauryn Hill's better because it has more soul.
They both
it has
more.
Fuck no. They would never see. No, fuck no.
I never got into that one, man. I don't know why. And I love like Tribe. I love Tribe. I just never got into that.
Yeah, like it's a
one day.
There's a spirit
it's not
that
many
moves with her.
Songs that I even like. That's probably what it is.
That man, my shit with him and fucking oh girl. It was when we were like in like yes, like
the
6-7. Yes, that's
someone
my
please
shit.
Please call 911. Man, we used to fuck that song up back
my
in the day.
Shit.
Tell them I just got shot down. And the bullets in my heart. Just a feeling.
My soul. Really, feeling it.
Feel my body getting cold.
Wow.
So
sometimes I feel like I'm a prison.
Because I do like that song. Yeah, but I just like to make fun of it more than
I just hate the way he screams that.
Feel my body getting cold.
He screams that. You know, I don't even know who that was for real. I just
couldn't. For a long time, I didn't know it was Wyclef. You know the Wyclef song I like? He had a song with The Rock.
The Wrestler?
Yes. It doesn't matter. He'd be like, oh, what how the fuck does it go? He'd be like, Rock, I got the keys to the new Bentley. He'd be like, it doesn't matter. I used to like that dumbass song.
It doesn't
damn
matter.
Damn it, I got to fucking get my YouTube to work.
It doesn't matter. I've heard that
you
shit.
You believe me.
It doesn't matter.
It played on
I heard
like
that
a motherfucker
shit.
Back in the day.
You know what song?
What is another
hold
one?
On, what's that Wyclef?
I can't think of another one.
Fuck.
Oh. He sampled the Bee Gees and did a song. I like that song. What the fuck is the name of it?
Is it new?
It's got the da 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 that song. You know what I'm talking about?
I've heard it.
I think it's called like Trying to Stay Alive or some shit.
I know.
Yeah, he sampled that song.
Yes.
Yeah. I like
so,
that song.
Let me just say, Wyclef, fuck you, because
woo!
You said somebody related.
I found it. Okay.
He said something about Young Thug being
like Tupac.
Yeah, like he compared him to like the greatest rapper of all time, like the greatest rapper of our generation.
Ooh.
That's what Wyclef thinks Young Thug is.
Oh yeah, fuck you.
So
Wyclef.
What the fuck are you on?
Yeah, fuck you, dude.
But yeah.
Which is why he is where he is.
Yeah, where is he?
Who knows?
Okay.
That's the song.
That is it, yeah. Yeah.
That's all right there. That's my shit.
Like
that's my shit. I do like that one.
He makes me want to like. Whenever I hear people like that, it just. Reassures me that I can go into the booth and do whatever the fuck
you,
I want.
People love your shit. Like, I don't know if Shayla know, I put his new song on the fucking podcast and people love that shit. There was people saying that shit.
Yeah.
No joke.
Yeah.
A couple people.
What? I'm sorry. You know I'm not the bragging type. No, because I don't
man, look, all right, man, fuck everything. I'm going to brag for him, man. I had people tweeting. I had people fucking video chat rapping. I had people, like, audio rapping. People
audio
love rapping. PJ shit. PJ gave me shit because on one episode, I read one of my old poems from like 2011 or some shit.
Yeah.
And he fucked with me. Next episode, I put his song on there. Because people loved the poem and the song. And I told him, can't you be on that shit? Because you do poetry too, motherfucker.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
Yeah. But people like our poetry on the fucking internet. I don't know why you ain't telling people that. That's some good shit.
That's some good shit.
Yeah. No, here, listen to Rock instead. That's what I was talking about right there. Camp, and you're about to smell if you hear this song. Rock is cooking. Remember this song?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my, that used to be my shit. Because I was a big wrestling fan, too, and I still
am. When did this shit come out?
2000. 17 years ago.
Yeah.
Rock was actually still wrestling.
Right.
He ain't start doing movies, I think, until the next year. There you go. I got 50 Bentleys in the West Indies. 8,000 miles. Yeah. I got a pocket full of cheese and a garden full of trees. 8,000
miles. I just won the bingo, bought a crib in Rio. 8,000 miles. Okay, this is cooler than I thought it would be.
It's always my shit.
The way you describe me, I'm like, what, the Rock?
Rock don't really say nothing other than
he doesn't matter. No, it doesn't matter. He makes it cool when he does it. Yeah, that's his catch.
You ain't ever watch wrestling back in the day?
I did.
Oh, okay.
I used to watch Booker T.
Oh, you watched WCW then? You one of them kids, huh?
And I watched Dwayne, The Rock.
Oh, okay. You might have saw it when everybody came together then. Because Booker T and The Rock was together. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's after 2001 or 2 then. Okay. Mm-hmm. After the WCW fell off.
Damn.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
It doesn't matter.
Is that like his stage thing that he said?
Yeah, that's one of his catchphrases. There we go. That's the beat I was trying to find. That's top billing. I don't know what my man's doing.
Oh, that's PJ dancing.
It was. Oh, I got video of that shit.
I bet.
Now, anytime that beat. MC and my people call me Milk. When I'm busting up a party, I feel no guilt.
Damn it.
Gears is cutting up for thee. Suckers, that's down for me. One of us, that's how I feel. To be down, you must appeal. Two for two, we're rated R. We're gifted and we're going far. Down the road to the bank. While I'm here, I like to thank Mom and Dad, they knew the time. Gizmo scotching, Milk is rhyming, Milk is chilling, Giz is chilling. What more can I say? Top billing, that's what we get.
You got it good.
And since you understood,
would you
stop scheming and looking hard? I got a great big bodyguard, so step up if you wanna get hurt. Milk is gonna pull this skirt. I get money, money I got. That's what the 50 Cent.
Call me honey when it feels real hot.
Yeah, that's like highly influential hip hop, right?
Yes, I just heard like something he just said that I heard.
MC Assault. In another song.
I know
it's all your fault.
You know that's MC Light's brother. I don't remember if it's Milk or Gizmo. One of them is MC Light's brother.
Wait, no joke.
Get the fuck.
Milk D.
That's his name.
Yep, right now.
Okay. That gotta be MC Light's brother.
About Milk.
That's gotta be his brother.
Oh man,
Milk D, MC Light, man, that goes together.
Light Milk.
Yeah. See what you did there. Light and Milk. Put a little cream in your coffee.
That's right, PJ. Though, I mean, PJ. Shayla don't know about the voices, do she?
No.
Ooh.
Is it that time?
Oh, do we want to do? Do we actually want to do it in front of a girl to see how this happens? Or do I just want to let you do it? Because it might be weird if I do it with you. In front of your girl.
What voice is this?
Oh, you want me? Okay, I'll start.
Just do it. Okay.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, God.
I guess it's about that time. Where,
I'm going to let Pete work.
We reached the end of the podcast, so.
That's why you guys said that I fit in perfectly, because I did the same thing.
Exactly. He just shushed her with his finger on her mouth.
Oh, I'm in my Mac Daddy pimp mode right now, baby. Like I was saying. The time has come for the podcast to end. I hope you enjoyed everything. And I do mean everything. Oh my God.
And I hope you enjoyed your special guest, Shayla M.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. If you did, go ahead and hit us up on one of our various platforms of social media. Don't laugh at me, baby. This is all real right now. It's the real deal.
Real shit.
Real shit.
Y'all want to follow us on Twitter?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all know how to do that by now.
How they do that?
You go on Twitter,
mm-hmm.
and you look for capital H, capital V, capital H, capital P, lowercase I-cast,
baby.
And you can find us on Twitter anytime you want, girl.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, what about Facebook?
Mm.
We got something on there, too, for you.
Mm.
It's real good.
Mm.
Facebook.com HVH podcast. You can find us on any podcatcher app, whatever you like, however you want it.
How do you want it?
Any way you like it. You can have it on Podbean. You can have it on iTunes. Mm-hmm. You can have it on Google. Hey, look, fuck you. Okay. Professionalism. Okay. I'm not editing this segment.
Don't do that.
We're going to give it to him.
We're going to give it to him raw.
Oh. Raw dog. All motherfucking night.
Damn right.
It is Friday night when you're listening to this. We know you like it raw after a good week of working.
Oh, yeah.
Like I was saying, find us on iTunes, Podbean, Google Play Music System. Anywhere. Search for us. We may just pop up.
Or something else might pop up.
Hey. It may get a little sticky though. You better be careful.
Oh shit.
God, that's hard to do with somebody.
Was that right? Somebody's watching.
God, Travis, this is fucking funny.
Oh, we do it way more often than we probably should.
That was so fucking hard.
I could not stop laughing.
I had to show you old episodes where we written real hard on that shit.
But yeah, on the real, follow us on Twitter, capital H, capital V, capital H, capital P, lowercase rcast. iTunes, Podbean, Google Play Music.
Anywhere.
YouTube. Podcast.
Everywhere. Make sure you look at the YouTube videos.
Yeah, every Wednesday. If you want to know what the fuck we're going to talk about on Friday, you got to watch the video on Wednesday.
If not, you're going to be fucked.
Or you can just wait till Friday.
Or you can just wait till Friday.
But see, if you wait till Friday, though.
You won't know.
You ain't in the hip, man.
Right.
You ain't
you
hip.
You got to keep up.
Yeah. Do that work. We put in that work for y'all every Wednesday. The least you can do. Just watch the video.
There you go.
And if you do, might be something special in it for you. I told you about that dough. You might get the bedroom dough. Hey.
Damn right.
Motherfucking right.
As always, thanks to all of our supporters.
Always.
Everybody who listens and clicks that download button.
Anybody who puts us in their ear holes every Friday.
I would have taken that somewhere, but that's a little far.
It's a little. But we're known for going far, ain't we, girl?
Damn right. For some reason, we still made it to one the mark. Right? That's what I'm saying. The same mark every time.
A long episode, man. No, it's the first time in like two or three episodes.
We went 140, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like 120.
Yeah.
Yeah. Y'all heard a whole bunch of tangents.
Y'all
and
heard
shit
a lot
tonight.
Of talking, not a lot of movie this week. But that's all right.
But that's what y'all like, isn't it?
We had a guest, though, so we had to let them talk.
Woo, woo.
Right.
She had to hear the voice.
Mm-hmm.
She gets to hear the PJ voice all the day, though. She laughs.
You hear that, women?
Ooh.
Oh,
shit.
I hear it all the time.
Well,
I'm not going to comment.
Yep.
Because I gotta talk to Shayla after this. So before this goes to 2 hours, I'm gonna just let y'all know something real quick. You ready for this, y'all?
What is that?
I'm Brent.
And this is PJ.
Have a good rest of your Friday. Have a good week. Have a good weekend. Have a good whatever the fuck day you're listening to this on.
Yes.
Go out there, have fun, do your thing. You know, use the voices, man. They work.
They.
We joke, but they motherfucking work. Yeah.
Fuck around.
Out here. See y'all next week.
Hustle, motherfucking.
Oh, P, before we go, though, we got to do something for Shayla because we usually do it every episode. We somehow avoided it.
What do we do?
I think she want to know, PJ.
I want to know.
She want to know, so we got to tell her.
What?
Tell me what I got to do to please you. Baby, anything you say, I'll do. Cause I only wanna make you happy. From the bottom of my heart, it's true. I wish that I could do it to y'all. Shayla.
Y'all, that was so much better in person.
Really?
Damn right.
That sounded
amazing
good.
Yeah.
Job. You should have saw that.
We got the vocals,
we
baby.
We got high praise.
Damn.
Oh my God.
Hold on, I'm a...
Oh, please, oh, babe. No, it's good. We're good.
I like to know. I want to know.
No. We got to do the other one.
What's the other
one?
Hold on. What's the... What we got?
7 o'clock on the dot. I'm in my drop top. Cruising the streets.
I got a real pretty, pretty little thing that's waiting for me. I pull up, anticipated good love. Don't keep me waiting. I got plans to put my hands in places I've never seen. Girl, you know what I mean. I wanna take you to a place nice and quiet. No one that I interrupt, ain't got a rush. I just wanna fuck you nice and slow.
Now baby, tell me what you wanna do with me. They call me U-S-H-E-R-R-A-Y-M-O-N-D. Now baby, tell me what you wanna do with me.
Do you wanna make love like Jodeci? Then they're trolling me, holding me, they're gonna throw me.
He had bars, baby. Wish I had bars like that. Damn.
Got bars. Oh man, Shayla, get
there. You
here.
Go.
All the greatest
hits.
Yeah,
right.
We do
in
shit
one
every
night.
Week.
Yeah, I must say, do you guys do these same songs?
Pretty much. Those are the two. Those are two.
Because
Joe is the staple.
Because it's always I want to know. Like we always want to know
because
something.
Because we
but
always
then
say like I
want to
know, and then it triggers something.
Yeah.
Every fucking week.
Yeah. Yeah.
Secrets of the
know.
Show out here.
Yeah. Right. We just
they
gave
know,
that
though.
Away.
They know. Yeah. They know. They know.
They know. Hello.
I'm trying to introduce new songs, but they don't catch on as much as those two, dude. I think those are two we know all the worst. All right, but for real, though, it's like almost 2 hours and we gotta go.
Yeah, sorry, guys. Hope you enjoyed this.
Oh, they will. I know they will.
Yeah, you will.
They probably don't even remember what movie we even talked about.
Yeah, right.
Halloween Havoc Month will continue, and there will be a bag the next 2 weeks.
Oh,
but the last
shit.
Week of the month, I'm
surprise.
Sure PJ. No, what would be
surprise
for you?
No, surprise. Oh, I'm getting the surprise.
You picked the first week. I picked the last week.
Okay.
And the last week, I'm picking my absolute all-time favorite horror movie ever made. And PJ has never seen it before.
No, I have not.
I'm not.
That's my best friend.
What? Well, it's more my core because I never showed it to him. So.
Oh, well, nah. Why?
I don't know. It just never came up. I never showed Die Hard. Die Hard is one of my favorite movies. Shit, I don't know.
It happens. Shit.
Once again, though.
Yes.
Come back every day, or not every day, every Friday for the rest of the month. Yeah, you know I mean, hey, please come back
every
day.
Every day. Yeah.
Binge this shit like Netflix.
Mm.
We'll be here.
Right.
And we're going to be ready.
Ooh, shit.
You want us that way? Gab us that way. Mm. You want us all night?
Mm.
Just hit that play button. It ain't going to never stop, girl.
Damn right.
Damn right. So once again,
yes.
I'm going to let you know, baby, that my name is Brent.
And this is PJ.
And we're gonna see you next week.
Hustle, motherfucking hustle.
Hey, peace.
There is no God.
Oh my God. You had to do it. I'm stopping.
There it goes. We're done.
Guys, we have to make a promo.
What's a promo?
Okay, John, let me explain to you what a promo is. It's like a little ad. And what we do is we'll make an ad, and then, like last week, we had Brent from the Home Video Hustle. He and PJ had their ad, and it was on our show. We dropped right in there. It was beautiful.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Sounded great.
Solid.
We're not going to sound that smooth, but we can do our own.
But we can try.
Yeah, we can tell them about the show.
We can do our darndest.
Man. Yeah, we can do our darndest, and we can tell them about what our show is.
What is our show?
Which is?
We talk about movies. We talk about music. We talk about pop culture. We talk about, there's nothing we won't talk about.
Food,
we,
politics.
We even talk about politics.
Yeah. Money.
Politics.
Talk about money.
That I don't have.
And movies.
But you know how you're going to get rich? Is if people listen to this promo.
Oh,
and
right.
So what we have to tell people is we say go to www.superioritycomplex.podbean.com. You can find us there. They can follow us on the Twitter at Soup Complex, S-O-U-P Complex. Like soup.
Yeah.
Everybody
like
loves
soup.
Soup.
I love soup.
Soup complex.
Soup is good food.
Give me some good chowder.
And you can go to Facebook and give us a like, and you can say, hey, facebook.com/soup complex. So that's an ad.
There you have it.
Yeah, we should do one of those.